Hello everyone, and welcome to Let's Try Fractured Space. I've played two games so far, so I'm really a beginner at this, but I'm starting to get the hang of it. I did the tutorial, of course. I'm currently level 2, so very much a newbie. But basically, this is a spaceship fighting game, similar to like World of Warships in space. There is another game, Dreadnought, that's come out. This is somewhat slower in pace than that game. And its objectives are a little bit more complicated, as we will soon see. It is a free-to-play game at this point. It originally wasn't, I don't think, and then it has become free-to-play, and still in development. So anyway, we get three basic kinds of ships once you finish the tutorial and start out: Pioneer, Sentinel, and Venturer, and they have attack, defense, and utility. They are expanded stats that you can look at, base hull strength, max speed, and stuff like that. And they have each special weapons and stuff. There is a variety of other ships that you can get with credits and experience. So I've got a little bit of credits, but not enough to get another ship right now. But you can see quite a selection of different types of ships. I mean, and they're beautiful, beautiful ships. I mean, take a look at that. So, I mean, visually it's very appealing in terms of, well, you definitely want to try out some of these ships and see how they do in battle. Other features are crew. You can edit your crew. You have a captain, a comm officer, a navigation officer, an engineer, and a tactical officer. And they have backgrounds and stuff like that, and you can change them. But right now I need to upgrade myself before I can upgrade my crew. But yeah, that is something else that is available to customize, and they all have skills and buffs and stuff like that. But let's not delay. Let us just launch and try this out. So now, obviously, I didn't actually have the ship that was displayed there, so it'll give me a choice. There is this conquest domination type game, which takes a little bit longer, and the most obvious difference between Dreadnought and this is that these games are a little bit slower in pace, and they're 5-on-5, by the way, 5-on-5 multiplayer. The frontline one, you have to be rank 5 to access that, so I'll probably make another video with that once I actually get to rank 5. Right now I'm only rank 2. It doesn't take very long to up the rank. It only took me 2 games to get to level 2, so I don't think it'll take me very long to get to level 5 either. But we might as well try this conquest mode first. Resources, sectors, and we have to overwhelm an enemy base. So let's play. I have no idea what Fracturoid Extreme is. let's just stick with this for now. Okay, we have a game. It took a little bit of time. It varies from depending on what time you're on, of course, like any multiplayer game, how quickly you can get a game. And of course, this is still early access, and it's not quite as hyped as other games like Dreadnought, for instance. So people haven't really caught on to it yet. Okay, so here you can see I get my selection of ships, and so I'll just go with the Pioneer and confirm ship. Okay, and then we get to select loadout, and I'm just gonna say ready because I haven't bought these other options, so you can upgrade your various things. Okay, so it starts you in this base ring, and actually we don't have to do anything right now because it's gonna start us again. Oop, there we go. Okay, now we're really started. And the first thing we want to do is jump. And it looks like my team is going to Beta 2, so I am jumping to Beta 2. You can see the map on the bottom right. And basically, we have to get to the red spot in the Beta sector or the Alpha sector. We have to catch one of those red spots in order to unlock the enemy base.
New target online.
Oop. And we can get upgrades by capturing various locations. This guy's capturing that. I'm gonna actually move on to the next one. It's WASD, of course, forward, back, left, and right. And space for up and left control for down. Okay. It's very much sounds pew pew. It's very pew pew. Oh, we got fighters. Oh, that guy. I'm still getting used to this. Okay, destroyed Ace Soldier 1170 and proceeding in is this T-Trains guy. Up, he's way below. He's trying to like flank us or something, I don't know. He's on the other side of that rock. Oh, got him. Okay, so we turn around and there's another guy. Oh, that guy got destroyed. Okay, so it looks like the enemy also went to the beta area. Most of the time it's split, and I don't know why we have one guy in alpha. It's better to concentrate your forces, obviously. And you can use the rocks to your advantage. And you have to be aware of your range. Okay. I think I'm just gonna...
Time to upgrade this crate.
Yeah, along the way we get upgrades. But we have to go back to base to do upgrades, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna capture this thing here, which would give us more points. So you can see a capturing bar at the top. And we want to capture the enemy. Oops. Okay, that guy's dead. Yay! I'm doing much better in this one than I did in the last one. On the two that I did before, those weren't very good. So, yeah, this is going well.
Command confirms we're taking a station.
I think I've got good teammates too. Totally benefiting from that. Oh, they want us to jump to Alpha to defeat them and make sure that the enemy can't go there. Let's close out Beta here and then we'll jump to Alpha to help the rest of our teammates. Well, okay, we can jump to the enemy base. It doesn't look like there's any jump ability to... Oh, okay, I thought they couldn't jump in, but looks like I was wrong. Aww. Huh. So they can jump in. Well, you learn something new every time. Somehow I destroyed Ingenious even though I wasn't there. Hmm. Okay, so then we get into this little warp place and I get to pick where I want to respawn. It looks like we need to help out the Beta 1 people. I don't know. Well, let's not be indecisive. I'll go to Alpha first. And then I follow those guys. Again, they're jumping to Gamma. I'll try and defeat that one guy out there. Or there might be two guys, actually. Let's reveal Sector. Okay. Okay. Well, maybe we should jump into Gamma Sector now. Gamma gives extra buffs.
I'm getting ready to jump.
So it unlocks and then you go in there and you get bonuses. And it looks like we've already secured it. So combat buff secured. I want to upgrade, let's say, my attack is pretty good so far. So let me upgrade my defense once I go back to a station. Where can I jump to? Oh, jump drive is still recharging. Looks like they're jumping to the enemy base, actually. Okay.
Well, the drive is spinning up.
I should have upgraded first, though.
The enemy are taking the base. Repeat. They are taking the base. Sons of...
The enemy is taking... No, no, we're taking the base. Okay, other bad guys.
New signal. Enemy ship.
They're these turret generators that we need to destroy. I think as I go around, I'll focus on that.
We no longer have jump access to the enemy base.
Well, then we better defeat the enemy here.
We have reports of an allied station capture. They have won the day.
Oh, we've won! That was quick. That was pretty quick. So yeah, that was good. Clearly a good team. So I'll do one more, I think. I wonder if I leveled up or anything. Unfortunately, there's this arbitrary 10-second cooldown period after victory. Okay, now we get to continue. Okay, victorious, and, okay, didn't quite make it to group captain, which is level 3, but, yeah, did okay. I mean, basically got halfway there, and, yep, a little bit more credits. Okay, I'm gonna play Pioneer again, because... I just want to focus on that while still learning the game. These others seem to be a little bit more specialized. I mean, attack is very simple, right? You just go in, plunge in, max speed, kill things. And defense and support, that's a little bit more specialized. So I will, after I am confident with my little Pioneer, I'll go on to the other two. Okay, and ready that. And you can see that not all of my teammates have the beginner ships. Protector, Ghost, Destroyer are not beginner ships. Destroyer, Colossus, Ghost, Reaper, Overseer, none of the enemy team's ships are the beginner ships. Okay, here we go. I'm just gonna see where they... Well, Alpha, Beta. Beta, okay, more for Beta, I'll go Beta. I'm entirely sure what's going there. Oh, we've been jammed. Well, geez. Oh, there's some bad guy over there. I'm gonna try and... Ooh. Yeah. I'm gonna try and get this place here. But there's clearly a bad guy there. I think that must be some kind of sniper ship to shoot at this range. This is bound to be a tougher fight. Oh, don't go out, don't go out. Okay, yeah, that guy is really annoying.
Our dorsal armor has taken a real pounding.
I got a heal from somebody, I think.
Here. I've spotted an enemy ship.
Okay.
Armor's down. Break off attack. I've lost the scanner feed.
The Ventura armor is home.
There's a lot. Oh, there's a T-Trains guy again. Ah, well. Oh, team imbalance. There's a team imbalance. One of our teammates got disconnected. Shoot.
I'm getting ready to jump.
So that's interesting. When a team member gets disconnected, you get a faster respawn. Good to know.
New
But wow, they had some special technology there. I'm gonna go after the T-train, Sky, since, well, that worked before. T-trains, like, why is there more than one T-trains? Is it, I think it's some sort of special ghosting skill, or is it just a generic thing that, is it an NPC or something? No, I think it's some, yeah, that's the ghost skill. That the ship is called Ghost, and that's because it can hide like that. Oh boy. Fighters, bombers. I need point defense on. We've lost power now, jeez.
We have orders to return for a refit.
Okay. I'm gonna try and get back into my base for the refit. The upgrade points. So I want better attack.
Offense upgrade selected.
Okay, wow, there's a lot of things shooting at me. So this ghost ship is pretty neat, huh? It's got sort of a hiding, cloaking thing going. Where's the other guy? Looks like our teammates really captured the other side, though. Okay, that's the other guy. Now, I don't know if there's any special tactical information to impart on this. Ah, that was a miss on the gravity nuke. Shoot.
The target is hurt. Their armor is gone.
Except, of course, it probably helps to keep moving. Okay, let's proceed forward here.
Alex here, I've spotted an enemy ship.
Okay, where, there he is. T-trains again. Lots of calm. I like that. There's a lot of communication from my crew. That does help to help it to come alive. Okay, I think we're jumping to Gamma.
The jump drive is spinning up now.
We are in danger of losing a station.
Oh, we've got jamming. Oh, all good. The enemy looks to be out there. This overseer has the sniping sort of thing. Okay. Ooh, it's potent. Well, we've captured this thing. Ooh. He's jumping. Okay. Alright, so let's jump. I don't know which way we should go. I probably want to go here.
Kindly remember to avoid combat during jump,
right? Yeah, let's just go this way.
Scanner show new contact.
Many bad guys.
Engines disabled. I got problems here. Jensen out.
Relax here. I've spotted an enemy ship.
Ouch, ouch. So launch gravity, maybe? I don't think the gravity nuke worked that time. So you can see the distance to the target in the bottom right hand corner of the target box. And I think my range is about 10 kilometers. Okay. Ooh, whoa, ouch, ouch. Alright, well, I don't see any bad guys, so let's proceed. Oh, there is a bad guy. And we can't spot anything. I don't know if reveal sector will undo that. Well, it looks like most of our forces are actually in beta doing battle there. So this is a much longer battle than our previous one. Okay, let's go to B. Beta.
I'm getting ready to jump.
Oh, that's that sniper guy again. Ouch, 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 ouch. Why must that be a thing? Okay, wow, we're really dying here. Ah, you can see the search beam. Jeez, this is bad. I'm so using the rock to block the way of the bad guy with the long range stuff. But this guy is not in range for me, really.
Camera 2 online. New signal. Enemy ship.
Okay, that guy's jumped out. This overseer guy's the trouble one though. Oh, he jumped out too. Hmm. Wonder where they're headed. I'm gonna try and cap the base then. Oh, they jumped to Gamma Sector. Is Gamma Sector open? None of my guys have jumped. Oh, now they've jumped. Yeah, I better jump and support.
Jump destination, past the drive. Me out.
Alarma! Alert!
I don't have much health. Let me go after this guy, who's really, really tough because of the sniping. Yep. Tough fella. Alright, looks like the best. Well, I've got one ally in Alpha, one ally in Beta, and both are sort of in the same situation for capping. I'll go to Beta since I've been doing that the whole time. Okay, bad things are happening. Oh boy. That guy really is irritating.
Scanner show new contact.
Stop it. Great. I don't feel like I have much support here. Yeah. This Bradburn guy has killed me a few times. Let's take a look. Well, he doesn't seem to have that many kills. I think it's just me. I'm not doing too good in this match. Oh, they've got one disconnected and we've got one disconnected. The ping, you might note, is not that great. Well, most of them are in Alpha, so I'll go to Alpha.
Engineering here. The jump destination is
or I thought there were two in Alpha, but apparently one died. Well, no, there are. There are two. Forward stations. I'll have to wait to see what my allies do.
A forward station has fallen.
Oh, bad guy. Sniper bad guy. Well, nobody seems to be jumping to Beta to stop them from keeping that. I think it'll be Gamma Sector in about 30 seconds. Oh, that is annoying the heck. I don't know what to do against this guy. This Sinaith. No idea what to do against him. Don't know how to counter that sniper beam. Okay.
Jensen here. I've had my bots working outside. The hull's fixed.
Alright, well, I see one ally in Alpha. I'll go there.
I have coordinates. We're ready to go.
forward station is under attack.
Oh, beam. Evil beam. Evil beam of death, I see it.
The enemy have taken a forward station. Home base is vulnerable. HQ.
Oh jeez, they're attacking our HQ. I gotta jump.
Prepping jump drive. Please avoid combat.
Defensive with the hull's taken a hammering. I'm working on it near out.
I think that if you shoot somebody while they're jumping, it does a lot more damage. Otherwise, I can't explain how I got that much damage. Okay, bad guy already destroyed. Any other bad guys? Okay, jumping to Alpha 2.
I'm getting ready to jump.
Okay, bad guy. Okay, I got Bradburn this time. So, I guess on we go. Try to capture the rest of these things.
New target online.
Okay, bad guy, where? There he is. Well, as you can see, these battles can take quite a while if things go the way they've been going in this match. Looks like we'll be trying to jump to Gamma Sector as soon as we get back in. Oh, or Ally Base, since it looks like there's a bad guy there. Well, that doesn't give us much hope of capturing Gamma Sector if we have to defend our own base. That's a good ploy by them. Yeah, well, it's already been lost. Gamma 4, I mean, the sector. So, only one thing to do is try and help our base. I don't know what the guy in Alpha is doing, but, you know, you can see the percentages at the top of the screen. Once our base gets 100% captured by the enemy, it's 66% now, well, that's the end of the game. That is the end of the game. Oh, they're all coming. Ah, defeat. Okay, well, that's that. That was sad. That was sad. But anyway, that's basically the flow of the game. It's not too hard to figure out. It can take some time. The ships look great. The ships look great. The sound quality, I think some of the pew-pew sounds might be a little bit improved. But it is fun. And I think, I'll probably, once I get to level 5, show you what the other game mode is like, the one that unlocks at level 5. I don't know so much about how grindy it might be. I haven't upgraded any ship, I haven't gotten any new ships, so I don't know what it takes to get to the top of the line or even know what that is. I don't know how many levels there are. Well, I played 2 games. It looks like I get a little bonus pack. No. I'll hold off for that. Okay, it is a cargo pod containing credits. One boost. I don't know what that does, but okay. It looks like I've gotten to level 3 anyway. I've been promoted to group captain. Next is sector captain. Everything is a captain, I guess. I don't know. I well know this commanders. It looks like, taking a look, I was senior captain. We had a senior commander. Senior commander, senior commander. There's a group commander. But apparently, I got teamed up with people up to level 7. I assume there are higher level peoples, but I wouldn't be matched with them necessarily. It might depend on what kind of ship that they were playing. I don't know exactly how the matchmaking works in this game yet. But anyway, so this is my attempt to try out Fractured Space. It looks great. I mean, so I'll probably be playing it a little bit more. Alright, so on that note, I'll say thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.